Hello friends, we'll be discussing another illustration which is related to the comprehensive problem of ratio analysis. Now that we have more details on the ratio analysis and the ways to derive how the ratios are supposed to be calculated, we'll be solving some more illustrations which is related to the comprehensive part of this chapter itself. Now, we'll be understanding certain ratios, or rather certain illustrations whereby the pre-made format is already provided to you of the balance sheet and profit and loss statement. On that basis itself, we'll be going ahead with the calculation of the other details. So let's figure out what the illustration mentioned down here. So the illustration has been mentioned down here. Let's read it out, what's been given here for your reference. You have to calculate the debtor's velocity from the following information. Opening balance of the debtor was mentioned as 10,000 rupees. Credit sales during the year were mentioned as 20,000. Sales return amounts to 1,000 rupees. Discount on sale amounts to rupees 50. Now the cash collected from the debtors during the year is 5,000. That means the total debtor which was had an opening balance of 20,000, out of that cash collected from the debtor amounts to rupees 5,000. Bad debts are rupees 500. And bad debt provision is supposed to be done at the rate of 10%. Now using all these details, we have to calculate debtor velocity. Now the following components are necessary to calculate debtor's velocity. So let's understand what exactly do we need to find out debtor's velocity first. So basically, when we talk about debtor's velocity, we understand that we are trying to find out the number of days a credit period can be given to a debtor. That is what we're ideally trying to figure out. So for that, we need first net sales. So to figure out net sales, the formula is the gross sales minus sales return plus discount on sales. That means the sales return part and the discount on sales part should be clubbed, and that much amount should be subtracted from the gross sales. That will give you the net sales here. So as mentioned in the question, gross sales amounts to rupees 20,000, sales return amounts to rupees 1,000, then discount that was provided on sales was rupees 50. So net sales has been figured out as 18,950 here. The next item that we have to figure out is net debtors. That means what is the exact amount of debtors that are supposed to be claimed back, or that the amount is supposed to be received back from them. So to figure out the net debtors, we ideally need to find out how much is the balance that we are supposed to receive. That means we need to have opening balance of debtors, in which we need to add credit sales, because debtor only come into question when there is a credit sale that happens. So we have to add as much of credit sale that has happened in the question. Out of that, whatever cash has been collected from the debtors will be subtracted. From that amount, whatever sales return has been done and the discount on sales return or other discount on sales will also be subtracted, because that doesn't amount to the amount that is supposed to be received from them. Because sales return, that means the amount has been given back, or rather the amount has been given back to the debtor, and the product which was given to him, he has sent it back to us. And the discount ideally refers as an expense for us and an income for them. That's why discount is a cash transaction that has already happened. So the closing balance of debtors is also found out, that is 23,950. Now with the opening and closing balance, we can figure out what is the average debtor that is available with us. So let's check that. That will be the third component. So average debtor has been also figured out, that is opening balance of debtor plus closing balance of debtor, that is 10,000 and 23,950 divided by 2 will give you 16,975. Now once average debtor has been cleared out, we need to further go ahead and figure out what is the debtor velocity. That means how many days of credit can we provide them. So to figure out that, we need to figure out how many daily sales that happens. So we need to figure out the average daily sales numerical. So to figure out the average daily sale, we need to have net sale value, which we have already derived earlier, which will be divided by the number of days in an year, that is 365. So the average daily sale here has been calculated as rupees 52. So now it's time to figure out what is the debtor turnover ratio. So the formula here is net sales upon average debtors, both the values we have with us. So the debtor turnover ratio that comes here is 1.12 times. That means that many times the debtor turnover ratio happens here in this business. Now let's figure out what is the calculation of days here. So if you have to figure out the calculation days, that means collection days here, number of days in a year will be divided by the ratio times. That means 365 divided by 112, that is 1.12 will happen here. So the collection period that we have figured out is 326 days. Now as we have figured out the debtor turnover ratio in times, the similar turnover ratio can be figured out in percentage as well. So let's figure out what is the value in terms of percentage. The only change that you have to do here is the formula will remain same, net sales upon average debtor. It's just that you have to flip it. That means average debtor upon net sales into 100 is what will give you the debtor turnover in terms of percentage. Now, if this has been found out in percentage, collection days can be also used or can be also figured out using this. The only difference is that when the collection period was supposed to be found out when the debtor turnover ratio was in times, then you had to do some different calculation. Here, you'll have to multiply 365 days by this percentage and you'll figure out the same days. Earlier, you divided 365 by the times ratio. Here, you'll multiply it. So the calculation comes to the same number of days, that is 326 days to be approx. So this is how you calculate the debtor velocity. Debtor velocity is basically calculating the debtor turnover ratio and the collection period of it, both in terms of percentage or in terms of times, either of it. If nothing has been mentioned in the question, you can calculate both percentage and time here. So I hope this video was good enough to give you clarity on the possible or rather concept of debtor velocity when it comes to ratio analysis using all these data and all these formulas. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and keep subscribing to Ikeda.